Kaitlyn. For those of you that don't know, I'm a certified fitness instructor, I'm a personal trainer, and I'm a yoga teacher. I have Annika joining us this morning for class, so that it's the two of us. She lives with me, so there is no self-isolation for the two of us. We are isolating together. So thank you for joining me for GFIT's Wellness Isolation Program. I'm happy to be hosting HIIT plus Yin this morning. So this morning we're gonna start off with a dynamic warm-up as well as mobility. And then we're gonna get into some high intensity interval training. And then we're gonna finish it off with a few yin postures. So we're gonna turn up the heat. It's gonna be pretty hard in the beginning. We're gonna warm up, take it a little slow, turn up the heat, and then we're gonna slow it down. So if you have any injuries, feel free to chat me. If you have any questions, you can answer or ask questions, but I will probably get to them after class. So we're gonna get started with some cat-cow. So if you don't have a mat, grab a towel. You'll need your water bottle. So we're gonna come onto all fours. So wrists below the shoulders, knees below the hips. We're gonna inhale. As we come forward, look up. We're gonna exhale as we tuck the chin to the chest, round the spine. Inhale, we come forward, look up. Exhale, we tuck the chin towards the chest. Inhale, we pull the shoulders back. Exhale, we round. So from here, you wanna make sure your wrists are below your shoulders. Your knees are below your hips. You exhale as you round. And you tuck, you inhale as you come forward. So big inhales, big exhales, we tuck the chin, we inhale, we come forward. Two more. Then we're gonna curl the toes under, send it up and back to down dog. We're gonna pedal the feet back and forth, pressing the heels down to the ground one at a time. Inhaling and exhaling, warming up the calves, the back of the legs. And then we're gonna walk it all the way back, touch our toes, big inhale, big exhale, reach. Then we fold forward, walk it forward, back to plank, all the way up and back. Big inhale, big exhale. We fold forward, hinge forward, stick your butt back. Try and keep your legs straight. Finding that high plank, up and back. Big inhale, big exhale. Hinging forward. Focusing on the breath. Optional push up, you can take it from your knees or your feet. Big inhale, big exhale. Two more. One more. Big inhale, big exhale. And we're gonna walk it up and back one last time. Big inhale, big exhale. Reach, hinge forward, fold forward. We're gonna go onto the ground and come into supermats. So hands are behind the head. We're gonna inhale, brace, exhale, lift the chest off the ground. Squeeze the glutes, keep the core tight. Big exhale, squeeze your butt. Try and keep that chest up. Engaging those glutes. Three more. Then we're gonna come into a high plank. We're gonna step our right foot next to our right hand. You're gonna take your right arm up, big exhale, we rotate. We step back to plank, and we switch sides. Left foot comes forward, big exhale, we open up. So from here, we're opening up our hips, our thoracic spine as we rotate. Big inhale, big exhale, we step it forward. Big exhale, we open up and rotate. One more on each side. Then we're gonna take a child's pose. I want you to come onto your hands and knees. We're gonna send the hips back, reaching forward with our arms, walk your hands over to the right, through center, over to the left. You're gonna continue side. getting nice and warmed up. Next up, we're gonna fire up the core and come into a hovering tabletop. So we're gonna come onto all fours. Wrists are below the shoulders, knees are below the hips. We curl the toes under, we hover. So you wanna make sure your hips are stacked above your knees, your shoulders are above your wrists. Option to make it harder here, we're gonna float our right leg. So you wanna flex your foot, and we hover and hold. We're here for another 15 seconds, and then we send it up and back to down dog. So big inhale, big exhale, send it up and back. Lock those feet out, pressing one heel down at a time. Take a few inhales, few exhales. And then we're gonna hit that hovering tabletop one more time in 3, 2, and 1. Back to hovering tabletop. This time, option to float that other leg. Yes, Anna, take it. Yes. Here for another 15 seconds. And then we're sending it up and back to down dog. 3, 2, and 1. Send it up and back to down dog. Walk those feet out. Five, four, three, two, and one. We come back to plank. We hold. Wrists are below those shoulders. Your gaze is 6 inches in front of your hands. And you're focusing on the breath. You want to squeeze your glutes. Float your right leg. Right foot down, float your left. Hop it forward, we're going right into squats. Our first series is gonna be squats. We're gonna move through a few squats. Then we're gonna hold, we're gonna pulse, and we're gonna hop. So we find that squat position, shoulder width apart. We squat down, we drop up. So we inhale, we lower, we exhale up. You want to think about driving your knees wide. Inhale, exhale. Two more. And then we hold. From your squat hold position, we're going to warm up with some clamshells. You're going to inhale the knees in, exhale the knees wide. Inhale, exhale. So maintaining that squat, we're firing up our glutes. Our glutes are our largest muscle here. So you really want to focus on exhaling. Knees wide, squeeze your butt. Try and keep your shoulders back, your chest nice and tall. So big exhale as you drive the knees wide. We're here for another 15 seconds. Then we're going back to those squats. In 5, in 4, 3, 2, and 1. Big exhale, we rise. Inhale. So make sure you're squeezing your butt up at the top and coming into full extension in your hips. 3 more.
Woo!
So shoulders back, get your shoulder blades together, sit the weight into the heels. Let's go, one back. 10 seconds here and then we pulse. A few inches up, a few inches down. Let's go, focusing on the breath. Woo!
Who cares how you made it there?
Back to squats. Big exhale up, inhale lower. Two more. Then we hold and we pulse. Let's go, Monica, let's go. Back to squats, big exhale up. We hit the other side in three, in two. squeeze your glutes. Last 40 second plank here. Draw everything in. We're almost there. Squeeze. Hold your back. 20 seconds here. You should be warmed up by now. I know I am. And I'm doing a lot less of the work than she is. Next up, we have some split squats. So a series where we're gonna pulse it out. So shoulders are back. Shoulders are stacked above the hips. Nice long stance. So when I hinge and go down, I want my knees stacked above my ankle. I exhale up. So shoulders back. Nice long back, looking forward. We inhale, we exhale, and then we're gonna pull. And then we're gonna move through a hop. We're going in three, and two, and one. So make sure you're breathing here. You inhale as you lower. You exhale as you rise. Wider stance there, Annika. Longer, yes. Two more, and then that back knee is gonna come to hover. Knee hovers, we hold. So from here, I want you to make sure your shoulders are back, your hips are forward, your joints are stacked. Hip, knee, ankle, both sides. We're breathing. Option to take those hands behind the head. We pulse it out a few inches up, a few inches down. Focusing on the breath. Then we go back to full range. Inhale. Exhale, all the way down, all the way up. Focusing on the breath. We inhale, we lower, we exhale to rise. Two more, and then hands behind the head. We hit that hop. Option to don't add the hop and just to continue. Take it or leave it. If it's too much on your joints, just move through the split squat. We're here for 15 seconds. Five, four, three, two, and one. We switch sides. Same thing on the other side. Long stance. Shoulders are back, core is on. We inhale to lower, we exhale to rise.
Should be on fire.
5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're going to finish with lunges. So option, just to do alternating lunges, option to have them off. 3, 2, and 1. Myself, it is quite the challenge. Oh, thank you for the compliments on the playlist. Some of my students think it's a little bit much playing the same songs, but I really like them. Aw, Alex, I miss you too. You're so sweaty. Me too. So we're gonna do some burpees. We're gonna do some hollow bodies. So Annika, show us a burpee. There's a few options. You don't have to go all the way to the ground like she did. She is a professional, but we'll hop it back into a plank, hop it forward. Hollow body is on your back. Some options here. You wanna tuck the pelvis, pull your shoulders up. Option to keep one heel on the ground, float one leg, take those arms up. Option two, float both legs. So again, we're pressing our low back into the floor. So we're gonna hit both of those moves three times through. Just tying my shoe here. So we have burpees first up. We're going in five, in four, in three. Almost there. You can do it. Last push of the day. Yoga, because I like the high intensity stuff, it is the best complement. So from here, we're going to come into a spinal twist. So you're going to lie on your back. We're going to have your right knee into the chest. So right knee comes into the body. We're going to inhale, exhale, slow down the breathing. You should extend your left leg long. You should be breathing heavy like Annika and I, maybe a little bit more like Annika than I. From here, we're going to take our right arm out at shoulder height. We're going to take an inhale, and on the exhale, we're going to take that knee across the body, and then we're going to look over our right shoulder. So from here, you want your hip stacked, your left hip below your right. You want to think about pulling that right knee across the body with the left hand, and then reaching and turning away from the twist to the right. So you wanna think about a little bit of a tug of war action. You're pulling that leg across, but you're really opening up through the chest. So this here isolates the IT band, because I know a lot of you got some tight IT bands, and then it opens up through the glute, through the torso, through the oblique, into the intercostal muscles, into the chest. So we're gonna be here for about another minute, and I'm gonna shut up to let you stretch this one out. And then we will switch sides. We're going to slowly come back. You're going to hug that knee into the chest again. And then we're going to release that leg, and we're going to switch sides. So you're going to hug the left knee into the chest. So focusing on slowing down the breath, taking some longer inhales and some longer exhales here. And then take an inhale, take an exhale. We're going to take that left knee across the body, guided by the right hand. We're going to take that left arm over shoulder height, turn your head to the left. So from here, I want you to focus on stacking your hips, one on top of the other, so your joints are stacked. Again, we're thinking about pulling this leg across, and then we're thinking about twisting and turning away. So again, you want to think about a little bit of a tug of war. And then focus on the breath, slowing down the breath. Every inhale, every exhale, trying to get a little deeper each and every time. slowly come back. So we're gonna take one of two options next. You can take figure four or pigeon. So if you have any knee pain, I want you to take figure four. You're gonna take one foot out and across your quad, and then you're gonna hug the leg that's bent into the chest. Try and keep your head on the ground here. If this is too much, you can always find a wall, which will help support you. Plant your foot and take that foot out and across. If you wanna take this a little deeper, you can come into the pigeon. So only if it's safe for your body, so coming onto all fours. Knee is right behind that wrist. You wanna square the hips, and we wanna take it down to the ground. So only if this feels safe. So if you're in pigeon and you feel any knee pain, low back pain, hip pain, I want you to lie on your back and take figure four, what Annika's doing. So from here, we're getting to the TFLs, the IT bends. Again, you want to focus on the breath. Think about inhaling for five through the nose and exhaling through the mouth. So really focus on slowing down the breath here. By the way, this is my favorite stretch. It is the best. I could sit in this all day. We're going to press into the hands. So if you're in figure four, you can just transition to the other side. If you're in pigeon, you can send it up and back, whatever feels comfortable in your body, and then switch sides. So again, squaring off the hips, making sure that you're not really sitting too much onto one side or staying square, keeping the weight balanced, and then coming on down. Then we're gonna press into the hands. We're gonna finish it off with the child's pose. So your knees below the hips. From here, we're gonna take our knees a little wider. We're gonna walk our hands forward and bring our chest down to the ground, bring your forehead onto the floor. So from here, you wanna think about being really heavy. You wanna think about letting go in your upper thoracic spine, sitting into the hips, onto the heels, and allowing yourself to be very heavy. Focusing on the breath, inhaling and exhaling. So really getting a stretch into our lats, which are our largest back muscles. Another 30 seconds and we're gonna call it a day. So take an inhale, take an exhale, press it in the hands, send it up and back to down dog. Pedal the feet back and forth. We're gonna lock our hands back and we're gonna fold forward. So allow yourself to be heavy here. If you have any low back pain, soft bend into those knees. Focusing on the breath. Slowly rise. Give yourselves a hand. Great job to my guests for putting in all the work. Give yourself. for a pat on the back. It was an absolute pleasure. And I'd really like to thank you guys for coming to my live class this morning. And keep your eyes peeled on GFIT Wellness, because they have an incredible isolation program. And they will have live classes for weeks and weeks to come until we are over and back to normal. I just want you to think of this as an opportunity instead of looking at this as something bad. I think it's really great that we're all moving our bodies and we continue to do so. So thank you very much, guys. Have a wonderful Sunday.